So today I'm going to talk about a project we did with Oklahoma Medical Research Foundation. This is a large non-profit biomedical research institute who combines patient care with research. So they have a number of research interests in different programs. And we've been working with arthritis and clinical immunology group to load their data in Transmart. So basically, part of the project, we had a number of studies, and it was two types of studies they had. So they had some completed studies. Some of could be like clinical trials, some could be some grant project, short project. And then also they have like live longitudinal cohort, which is ongoing study. And because the study is ongoing, that they wanted to have frequent updates. So, and another challenge was that the same patients participated in a number of studies. So it's not easy to separate just patients between studies. It's easy, but then you have to kind of account that this is the same patient. And basically, another challenge with using Transmart in particular was that they didn't have, a lot of studies didn't have scheduled visits, basically, which kind of doesn't work nice with Transmart because a lot of times you have to assign visits. And Transmart doesn't understand dates. Another interesting thing from curation perspective was we couldn't do just usual process where we get files or downloads them from database, do curation, prepare them for Transmart, load it, and we're done. In that case, they basically, OMRF didn't want us to do any changes. They want to do, like, if any changes needed to be done, they wanted to do it at database side. So basically, curation part was looking at the file, finding any inconsistencies, any errors, anything which needs to be done differently, and then give this list of findings to OMRF, and then they will do any changes on their database side, and then once we re-download this data, we get Transmart ready files to download. Because several patients participated in several studies, we decided to load data differently and use different logic in Transmart tree. So basically, all the subject demographic information was loaded together without dividing between studies. So we don't have repeated information for the same patient. But then all the other information, like clinical clinical, experimental, anything else which was done in the study was actually loaded by study. So instead of usually have like clinical note, clinical, in this case, clinical note would be inside of study note. So you open up study, you select study you are interested in, and then you can see what type of data available for this study. And we also made separate subject participation note. So if you want to just look, make quick cohort just by that study, it would be easy. So because it's an ongoing longitudinal cohort and there is no set of visits, because sometimes these cohorts used by to select some subject for specific study, and there is no defined baseline visit in a lot of times. So it's making it hard to calculate date of study. So, and unfortunately, Transmart doesn't understand dates since this functionality of E2B2 was disabled. So we had to kind of work a lot with scientists to discuss how they need to use the data, what they want at the end, and basically trying to understand how data would be used. So we still loaded the dates, but for now, they're mostly for informational purpose. So we divide it by studies, by visits. But if anybody interested in finding which date it was, then they can also do that. And but we had to go by, we had to go by visits. And pretty much in conclusion, we was able to load the data in Transmart, but we had to work closely with OMRF team to understand what their needs are and how they want to use the data. And a lot of times it was also educating OMRF team how to use Transmart or how Transmart handles the data. And also I see that a lot of other places also want to see like some solution for dates in Transmart rather than just using visits. And hopefully next version of Transmart, when it's released, will have addressed some longitudinal studies and get more workflows. So I just want to thank OMRF team for letting us work on this project, and as well as Rancho team who worked on this project. Thank you. Hopefully it's quick enough.
It was very quick.